السلام عليكم ورحمة الله. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله سيدنا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين. Part of belief in the messenger is believing in the messenger who has been sent to us, namely the final prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, obeying him and following his way and path. He is the final messenger and there is no prophet after him. As Allah سبحانه وتعالى said, ما كان محمد أبا أحد من رجالكم ولكن رسول الله وخاتم النبيين. محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم is not the father of any of your men, but he is the messenger of Allah and the last of the prophets. And when the messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم went out to Tabuk and left Ali ibn Abi Talib in Medina, Ali رضي الله عنه said, أتخلفني في الصبيان والنساء? Are you leaving me in charge of the children and women? The prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, ألا ترضى أن تكون مني بمنزلة هارون من موسى? إلا أنه ليس نبي بعدي. Does it not please you that you are to me like Harun to Musa, but there will be no prophet after me? The Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم was sent to all of mankind to be obeyed and followed. Allah سبحانه وتعالى says, وما أرسلنا من رسول إلا ليطاع بإذن الله. And we didn't send any messenger but that he should be obeyed by permission of Allah سبحانه وتعالى. Which means that obeying the Prophet was ordained and enjoined for those to whom Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the Prophet. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَآمِنُوا بِاللَّهِ وَرَسُولِهِ النَّبِيِّ الْأُمِّيِّ الَّذِي يُؤْمِنُ بِاللَّهِ وَكَلِمَاتِهِ وَاتَّبِعُوهُ لَعَلَّكُمْ تَهْتَدُونَ. So believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his messenger, the unlettered prophet who can neither read nor write, who believes in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his word, and follow him that you may be guided. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala made a connection and combined between obedience to him and obedience to the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. And he said, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَطِيعُوا اللَّهَ وَأَطِيعُوا الرَّسُولَ. O you who believe, obey Allah and obey the messenger. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala described obedience to the Prophet as being part of obedience to him. And he said, مَنْ يُطِعِ الرَّسُولَ فَقَدْ أَطَاعَ اللَّهَ. He who obeys the messenger has indeed obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also commands his servants to refer all disputes to him and to the messenger. And he said, فَإِن تَنَازَعْتُمْ فِي شَيْءٍ فَرُدُّوهُ إِلَى اللَّهِ وَالرَّسُولِ إِن كُنْتُمْ تُؤْمِنُونَ بِاللَّهِ وَالْيَوْمِ الْآخِرِ. If you differ in anything among yourselves, refer it to Allah and his messenger, if you believe in Allah and in the last day. Mujahid رحمه الله and several other among the Salaf and scholars said, أي إلى كتاب الله وسنة رسوله. Refer to the book of Allah and the sunnah of his messenger. This is the command from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that whatever area the people dispute about, whether major or minor area of the religion, they are required to refer it to the Quran and the sunnah for judgment concerning these disputes. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إن كنتم تؤمنون بالله واليوم الآخر. If you believe in Allah and in the last day. And this indicates that those who don't refer to the book of Allah and the Sunnah for judgment in their disputes are not believers in Allah or the last day. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, فَلَا وَرَبِّكَ لَا يُؤْمِنُونَ حَتَّى يُحَكِّمُوكَ فِيمَا شَجَرَ بَيْنَهُمْ ثُمَّ لَا يَجِدُوا فِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَرَجًا مِّمَّا قَضَيْتَ وَيُسَلِّمُوا تَسْلِيمًا. But know by your Lord, they can have no faith until they make you, O Muhammad, judge in all disputes between them and find in themselves no resistance against your decision and accept them with full submission. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala swears by his glorious most honorable self that no one shall attain faith until he refers to the messenger for judgment in all matters. Thereafter, whatever the messenger commands is the truth that must be submitted to inwardly and outwardly. The believer submit to the Prophet's decision with total submission without any rejection, denial, or dispute. And the Prophet Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم said in the hadith, لا يؤمن أحدكم حتى يكون هواه تبعا لما جئت به. None of you truly believes until his desires are subservient to what I have brought. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إنما كان قول المؤمنين إذا دعوا إلى الله ورسوله ليحكم بينهم أن يقولوا سمعنا وأطعنا. The only saying of the faithful believers when they are called to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Messenger to judge between them is that they say, we hear and we obey. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala warned us not to go against the Prophet and state that whoever disobeys him will be doomed to endless hell. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, فَلْيَحْذَرِ الَّذِينَ يُخَالِفُونَ عَنْ أَمْرِ أَنْ تُصِيبَهُمْ فِتْنَةٌ أَوْ يُصِيبَهُمْ عَذَابٌ أَلِيمٌ. And let those who oppose the Messenger's command beware, lest some trial or affliction may befall them, or painful punishment may afflict them. Obeying and following the Prophet Muhammad ﷺ means obeying and following his Sunnah. The Sunnah is the words, deeds, and approval that are attributed to the Prophet. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent his Prophet with Islam. And this great blessing is not only the Quran, rather it is the Quran and the Sunnah. It is essential that it be established in the mind and heart of every Muslim that the Sunnah is one of the two parts of divine revelation that have been revealed to the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The other part of the revelation is the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يَنْطِقُ عَنِ الْهَوَى إِنْ هُوَ إِلَّا وَحْيٌ يُوحَى. He, the Prophet, doesn't speak of his own desire. It is only a revelation revealed. The Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam stated that the Sunnah that he brought is like the Quran in that it is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When he said, أَلَا إِنِّي أُوتِيتُ الْقُرْآنَ وَمِثْلَهُ مَعَهُ ألا يوشك رجل شبعان على أريكته يقول عليكم بهذا القرآن فما وجدتم فيه من حلال فأحلوه وما وجدتم فيه من حرام فحرموه ألا وإنما حرم رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم كما حرم الله. Indeed, I have been given the Quran and something similar to it along with it. But soon there will be a time when a man will be lying down on his couch with a full stomach and he will say, you should take on this Quran. What you find that it says it permissible, take it as permissible. And what you find it says is forbidden, take it as forbidden. But indeed, whatever the Messenger of Allah forbids is like what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala forbids. And the importance of the Sunnah is first of all that it explains the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Then it adds some ruling to those in the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, وَأَنْزَلْنَا إِلَيْكَ الذِّكْرَ لِتُبَيِّنَ لِلنَّاسِ مَا نُزِّلَ إِلَيْهِمْ وَلَعَلَّهُمْ يَتَفَكَّرُونَ. And we have also sent down to you, O Muhammad, the dhikr, reminder, and the advice, which is the sunnah, that you may explain to mankind what is sent down to them, and that they may reflect and give thought. This means explaining things that are mentioned in general terms in the Holy Quran, just as 5 daily prayers, their time, sujood, ruku, and all other ruling. It was narrated that Imran ibn Husayn radiallahu anhu was sitting with two of his companions when a man among the people said, don't quote anything to us except the Quran. He said to him, come closer. So he came closer. Then Imran ibn Husayn radiallahu anhu said, أرأيت لو وكلت أنت وأصحابك إلى القرآن أكنت تجد فيه صلاة الظهر أربعة وصلاة العصر أربعا والمغرب ثلاثا تقرأ في اثنتين. What do you think if you and your companions rely only on the Quran? Would you find in it that the Dhuhr prayer is 4 rak'ah and Asr prayer is 4 rak'ah and Maghrib is 3, of which you recite something other than Al-Fatiha in 2? What do you think if you and your companions rely only on the Quran? Would you find the Tawaf around the Kaaba is 7 and that going between Safa and Marwa is 7? Then he said, Umran said, خذوا عنا فإنكم والله إلا تفعلوا لتضلون. O people, learn from us. For if you don't, you will go astray. الإمام الأوزاعي رحمه الله said, الكتاب أحوج إلى السنة من السنة إلى الكتاب. The book, the Quran, needs the Sunnah more than the Sunnah needs the Quran. Following the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم and his way is the mean to attain the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, his forgiveness, his mercy, and his jannat. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for forgiveness, for his mercy. Allahumma innaka afuun tuhibbul afwa fa'afu anna. Rabbana atina fi dunya hasana wa fil akhirati hasana wa qina azaban nar. Rabbana taqabbal minna innaka antas samiul alim wa tub alayna ya maulana innaka antat tawwabur rahim wa salli allahumma ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wasallim. Wassalamu alaykum wa rahmatullah.